Preserving stem cells from a baby's cord blood was introduced back in the 90s. Back then, it was an expensive process and was used for certain cancers, mostly in children.
As our morning anchor Natalie Pozzo explains, now advances in medicine are changing the way this process could be used to help adults.
These are very powerful stem cells.
Lauren Isley is with Cooper Surgical, the parent company of Cord Blood Registry. Isley says blood from the umbilical cord and placenta, along with cord tissue, are being used for more than certain cancers, blood, and immune disorders.
We've actually seen cord blood and cord tissue being used in newer applications in this newer area of medicine called regenerative medicine. And regenerative medicine looks to repair and regenerate damaged cells and tissues and organs in the body.
Isley says some of the research and clinical trials happening right now are for ALS, Parkinson's, and Alzheimer's.
A lot of these are adult onset conditions. You're not going to see them pop up in a person or a family until, you know, perhaps they're 30, 40, 50 years old. So I think where we thought about cord blood in the pediatric population a little bit more, now we're thinking of the older generation when it comes to regenerative medicine treatments.
Isley says if you're a close enough match, you can potentially use your child's stem cells and your other children can too.
It's a very rapidly developing field, and something that was thought to be impossible 10 or 20 years ago, now it's, we can do that. It's not a problem.
At Nova Southeastern University's Cell Therapy Institute, they're developing new approaches using stem cells, repairing damaged and aging tissue for neurodegenerative diseases like Alzheimer's.
There are therapeutic benefits in preclinical models, but what I say to people is once there is something that is really big, like a big breakthrough, you will read about it in the news.
Dr. Vladimir Bojensky believes there will be major advances in the next 5 to 10 years, but does not think stem cells need to be preserved.
If we have a universal cell, I don't necessarily think that will be necessary. If this field continues moving as fast as it's doing now, I don't think it's going to be a wait list. I think it's going to be actual stem cell clinics that will be supported by insurance, meaning it will be really testing that those therapies are working.
There are some benefits of getting these stem cells from the cord blood and cord tissue when they're brand new. They haven't had a lifetime of exposure to viruses and other environmental toxins. So research has shown that newborn stem cells in their naive state actually have some benefits over those adult sources of stem cells.
There are several companies that will bank cord blood and tissue. Cord Blood Registry offers plans starting at $925 with an annual storage fee of $200. They also have financing options.
Now, if a family decides not to store, the cord blood and tissue is thrown away. It can be donated, though, to a public bank for someone who may need it or if it's needed for research. A link to a list of those participating hospitals can be found on our website, WPBF.com.